Hello, I'm Leemon Baird, and I'm here to talk to you about sustainability on Hedera using the Guardian system. So everyone is concerned about carbon emissions and buying carbon credits and believing them and having trusted carbon credits. This is the system. Guardian has been built by the Hedera ecosystem, multiple different people working together to allow you to buy and sell carbon credits, to verify them, to trust them, all of that. So let's talk about that. The balance sheet of the planet will live on the public ledger. This means that all of the carbon emissions and carbon credits can be on a ledger, on a blockchain, on Hedera. And this is the future. The future is that these will all be tokenized and put on a ledger because there's so many advantages, especially in making sure that you can trust it. If it is on a ledger, then everyone sees the same thing. Auditors can say the same thing that the buyers are seeing. Buyers can buy a token and you can be sure that it wasn't resold to someone else also and trying to sell the same carbon offset to two different people, which would be, you know, illegal and fraud, but wouldn't necessarily be easy to catch if it's just on paper. But if it's on a ledger, it'd be obvious. You can actually prevent some of those frauds. So this is why this kind of thing, carbon credits and carbon offsets and carbon emissions, are all going to end up being recorded on ledgers. And Hedera is leading in this, both because Hedera itself is green and just because everyone who trusts it and its greenness has been building on it. And the Guardian project is a great example of this. So in order to do this, we want to have the balance sheet of the planet on a decentralized ledger, providing credibility through transparency. So many people in the ecosystem got together and started to look at the problem. Well, what is the problem? Well, here's something from Microsoft. This was a quote. They said, there are not enough verified is the key word, carbon offset credits in the world today, just to satisfy Microsoft's needs for this year. So there are lots of carbon credits being sold, but they're not actually being verified. You don't know that you can trust them. And if you just look at the ones you can trust, there aren't even enough to satisfy Microsoft's needs, much less the needs of the whole world. This was the problem. And so as an ecosystem, many different organizations got together and said, here is our challenge, and made a list of the challenges. The challenges are that claims of sustainability credentials are very hard to verify and validate. Someone says they bought carbon credits. How do you know they're real? How do you know they actually bought them? How do you know they weren't done twice? The credits also could be themselves invalid. I save a tree, so I sell a credit. Well, did I sell this two credits for the same tree? And did I really save the tree? Was it one that was going to be cut down? Did I actually save it? Or was it just a tree sitting there? These are all questions you have around validating and verifying the credits. And then if you have a voluntary carbon markets like we have right now, there's questions about the consistency of the methodologies. So the methodologies are the rules for how do we account for it? How do we report it? What counts as a ton of CO2? What counts as a carbon credit? How do we verify these things? These are the methodologies, the rules. And there's inconsistencies. Different projects may use different definitions of a carbon credit. So I say I emitted a ton, and you say you saved a ton, and so I buy your ton to offset my ton. But if you've defined the ton differently than I've defined it, that doesn't make sense. So we need to have consistency. This is a challenge. And then there is eroded credibility right now among consumers and investors and stakeholders because of fraud and because of confusion and because of inconsistency. All of these issues have eroded credibility of the entire system. And we have fragmented standards, as I was talking about. So these are the challenges that we as a community saw. So the solution that we came up with was the data and ecosystem on the ledger. We have increased transparency and provability because it's on a ledger. Everyone can see it. Everyone knows they're seeing the same things. It isn't possible that you're seeing one thing and I'm seeing something different. We all see the same thing. It's trusted. We can have trusted markets where we buy and sell these credits. We can have verification that is auditable. And you can audit the verification. So auditors or verifiers will audit the data, and then other people can audit the auditors. We have standardization of policies and digitize those policies, digitize those methodologies so that computers can see them and know that we're all on the same page and build a thriving ecosystem. So this was the solution. And this is why this group around of Hedera organizations, different organizations that are built on Hedera, got together and created Guardian. So Hedera is the trust layer of the internet. Guardian is making it the trust layer of the planet. Hedera, of course, is this DLT, distributed ledger technology, built on Hashgraph. It has advantages over simple blockchains and huge advantages over proof of work. It's at the bottom there. It has a token service and a consensus service. Consensus service is how you store data. You can send data through Hedera that will be stored forever, immutably, very inexpensively. You can do it 10,000 times a second. And the token service allows you to create tokens, NFTs. You can tokenize a carbon credit. You can tokenize a carbon emission. You can sell, buy and sell your token carbon credit. You wouldn't buy and sell the emission, but you can hold it. And then you can on the ledger show how they match up. And so people can see that your emission and your credit are matched up. If you buy a credit to offset it, you can see that it's offset. So this is how Hedera works. And it works with mirror nodes, remembering the data forever. We have a huge council of all of these big names that you recognize, top 10 universities and Fortune 100 companies and continents around the world. And they act as checks and balances on each other. They own Hedera. They govern Hedera. They are the ones that decide what code goes on the network and what the prices are and what the rewards are and who will be in the council. The council itself decides who will be in the council next. And we have 29. We're going to go to 39. And that's what we're doing right now. We're continuing to add council members. But these council members not only believe in Hedera, they're even using it. I'll tell you about some of them who are actually using Guardian right now to do all these things with tokenization and offsets of carbon. So we have this enormous ecosystem, and Guardian is just one more piece of this ecosystem. And it takes advantage of the existing ecosystem. So why build Guardian on Hedera? Well, one good reason is that Hedera itself, in addition to being very fast and very inexpensive and very well governed, which are important things and very secure, very important things, it's also very green. Hedera itself is green. So for example, UCL published a paper comparing the carbon footprint of lots of different ledgers and of the Visa credit card. This is how much carbon you dump into the atmosphere when you do one transaction on any of these ledgers, and you can see down there in the middle is Visa, or if you use or swipe your Visa credit card. So this is showing you carbon emission for one transaction. And on Hedera, it is 0.000003 kilowatt hours per transaction. Very little energy is used, very little carbon footprint. For the other ledgers, there's quite a bit more. You can see the next one is 19 times worse. 19 times more carbon is dumped into the atmosphere. And the one after that is 170 times. It goes into the hundreds and then into the thousands. A Visa card, when you swipe your credit card, puts 1,000 times more carbon into the atmosphere than Hedera does for a transaction. And then Bitcoin, of course, I couldn't even fit on the chart. It's almost a trillion times as bad. But that's because Bitcoin does that on purpose. It burns electricity in order to do this. And these are showing you the carbon that we put in the atmosphere. You could say, well, what if there's a solar panel? And then the solar panel is giving them their energy. So that kind of offsets their energy usage. Yes, but then that's a solar panel someone else can't use. So just because you used solar panels doesn't mean that you're very green. So to be inherently green, you use less energy, because then the planet as a whole can use that solar panel for something else. So the greenest you could possibly be is to not use energy. The greenest form of energy is megawatts. Those are the watts you don't use. And so Hedera is the greenest in that sense. But it is also legit for these other ledgers or anyone else to buy offsets. Offsets are a legitimate thing to buy. So then you do go find a solar panel somewhere and you say, I'm going to buy your offset. So now I'm green because I've offset my usage. But we have to make sure it's a real credit, that it's a real solar panel, and that the solar panel's credit was only sold once, not sold to two different people. And that when it was sold to someone, they didn't use it as an offset and then sell it after they had used it up. You have to make sure there's no fraud. You have to make sure it's auditable. This is what Guardian is about. So Guardian's built on Hedera because Hedera is fast, fair, secure, well-governed, but also because Hedera is inherently green. And then, of course, Hedera buys carbon offsets themselves. So every transaction on Hedera is offset with carbon credits. We've been doing this for a while now, buying carbon offsets to be carbon neutral and then buying a few more to be carbon negative. And so we ourselves do this. Lots of people do this. This is why we needed Guardian. So that's why Guardian was built on Hedera and why Hedera needs Guardian. Both. Guardian needed Hedera and Hedera needed Guardian. So what is Guardian? So it's an open source framework. It's all open source. It's all been created by the community with to incorporate standards as much as possible, to interoperate with existing systems as much as possible, and to bring it all together to make it easy and a no-brainer, no effort for you to create tokens, carbon credit tokens, to consume the carbon credit tokens, to buy and sell them in markets, all of these things, to audit them, to know what the methodology is, the set of rules that are being used, all of that. So the goals in creating this was to make it auditable and to have these methodologies digitized so that the computers can see what the rules are and we can see if different people are using the same rules, the different methodologies, different approach. We want to make it scalable. In fact, we want the VVBs, the validation and verification bodies, the VVBs, they're the ones doing the verification. They're the ones doing audits. We need to make sure that they are scalable to make sure that it's accurate, that it's telling the truth. And not just to eliminate intentional lies, but also to eliminate accidental lies, accidental mistakes. We're just using different, we're talking past each other, using different definitions. And so I think I bought a credit and you think you created a credit, but they're not the same kind of credit. They don't actually match up. We want to avoid that kind of thing too. So we need it to be accurate to avoid both lies and accidental mistakes. And we need to have a market. And so markets use online markets. So we have DEXs and things that can buy and sell these tokens. And usually you need a market maker, an automatic market maker, an AMM. And so we have the automated regression market maker, ARMM, ARMS. This is part of the project to create a market maker for these carbon offset tokens, carbon credits. And we want to make the ESG reporting credible so that people can have trust in the system. And so that is what this is all about. So we worked on all of that. And how does that work? Well, the way it works is, I look at the left column, you have methodologies as a third one down. The methodologies, the rules are what we're going to do. They define who the actors are. And who are the actors? Well, they're individuals, they're enterprises, they're governments, they're auditors, they're regulators. They all get defined in the methodology. And then it defines what data do we need. The data about devices, the data about systems, the data about people. And then, of course, the data about my solar panel created this many kilowatt hours today of green energy. My factory emitted this many kilowatt hours or many tons of CO2 into the atmosphere today. All that stuff. So we need data on all of those things. So there's data about the actual emissions and the actual credits. And then there's also data about all the different participants and data about how it all links together. Lots of data. All of that gets fed into Guardian. That's in the middle column here. Guardian is in the middle, right above Hedera. And Guardian is then able to take all that information and digitize the methodology so that computers can read it, digitize the data so that we have it. It can be then sent through the consensus service so it is stored forever immutably and the entire planet sees it. You have all these pieces of data that are linked together with hashes. And then the final hash, Guardian can mint a token, or someone can use Guardian to mint a token that contains the hash of all that data. So the token service creates a token for, say, a carbon offset. The consensus service has all this data that you've sent out maybe over the last year or last decade about that's relevant to that token. And then the token contains the hash of the last piece of that chain of data. And so it has all that data in a sense inside of itself. And none of it can be changed. It's all immutable. You can rely on it not changing. You can rely that everybody sees it, and then you can audit it. And because things are digitized, like the methodologies are digitized, you can have the auditors use automated systems that can see what the rules are when they're trying to verify the rules. All of that. And then you have marketplaces where you can buy and sell these, and you have wallets. People can have wallet software that remembers their tokens and manages them. All of these things work together. This is how the whole thing works together so that as a community, we can be creating these things. We can be dealing with each other in ways that we trust, even though we don't necessarily trust each other. We can deal with strangers that we don't trust, and we can make them all work together. Given this, with Guardian the Sitter here enabling it all, what do we end up with? What you end up with is this whole ecosystem. I won't go through this slide, but I just want you to see how many different pieces there are in this ecosystem and all the different pieces talking to each other, and there's arrows going every which way. You have Guardian there and Hedera over on the left side in purple, but you just have lots of different pieces to this ecosystem. And so once Guardian was created by multiple people in the Hedera ecosystem, then you have all these other pieces that come in, and includes things like DEXs, saucer swap is listed up there, all sorts of things to allow you to buy and sell these tokens and to trade them. And it allows you to create tokens for your carbon credits that then people can buy and use. You can even tokenize your emissions. Now, you wouldn't transfer that to somebody else. You don't buy and sell emissions. Emissions are your liability. But what you do is you tokenize it, and that puts on the ledger this immutable record. I have emitted some carbon. And then later, if you buy a carbon credit to offset it, that's on the ledger. And the ledger shows that you've bought it. And the ledger can show that the two are hooked up with each other and that this credit offset this emission. And that now is immutable and is there forever. And everyone can be sure that you're not going to resell this token because you've already admitted that you've used it. So it's used up. It can't be resold. And everybody can audit this. This is the way the ecosystem works. So is anybody actually using this thing? Yes, this has a lot of traction. There are a lot of people using this. I'm just going to give you 8 use cases very quickly in my last 3.5 minutes. But there is a huge ecosystem of people using Guardian and the things that it enables. So Avery Dennison is tracking literally billions of objects through supply chains. Every second, they send 1,000 transactions to Hedera through the Atma project just to record things in this supply chain. And they want to make the supply chain green. So they want to track carbon emissions at every step along the way so that some final user might be able to buy offsets. Or you could even buy offsets in the chain itself. And so some of these might be carbon neutral because it has a record of a carbon emission and a record of a carbon offset, and the two were put together, and it even records that. So you can have green supply chains, green because they're carbon neutral, or green because they have carefully recorded their exact carbon emissions so that someone else can deal with them and make them carbon neutral. This is what Avery Dennison is doing, tracking the supply chain. Then you have ServiceNow, and they are doing the tokenization as a service for the carbon credits or the carbon emissions. You can do both. You can tokenize both and you can match up the tokens. Then you have markets for one of those two. For the carbon credits, you have markets. You don't really have markets for emissions. Although I can imagine cap and trade regulations in the future, maybe even creating markets for that. But yeah, whatever. Right now, it's carbon credits and emissions that are being tokenized. You would trade the credits. You wouldn't trade the emissions. ServiceNow, of course, is enormous. Software as a service company for technical management support. Everybody knows ServiceNow. Everybody uses ServiceNow. And they are doing this to be green. They're using the token, doing the tokenization, and it plugs into the Guardian ecosystem, and it's all built on Hedera. Then you have Standard Bank. They're doing green bonds. And so they're going to be able to sell green bonds that will be doing this green stuff. And they're doing the self-sovereign identity. So identity actually is a very important part of this. Being able to prove that you are you when you're buying and selling and you're dealing with people and being audited and creating the credits, you wouldn't believe a credit from a stranger. You need to know who they are so you can audit them. So they're doing self-sovereign identity work as well. Very important part of this. We could have a whole talk on identity. Identity is incredibly important. Then you have Timeless. They are doing this decarbonization that is auditable and verifiable, creating the tokens. Another one, they're a world leader in sustainability solutions. This is another project built on Hedera, using Guardian, making all of this real. And you have Dovu, and they have a trusted tokenized carbon marketplace. I told you, these tokens aren't useful unless you have markets. So they're creating the markets. See all the different pieces? Some people track, some people create tokens, some people now have markets for tokens. There's all sorts of different pieces of this puzzle, and they're doing it. We have people right now on board on this, and they're doing this. They're using Hedera to do these things. So we have Tovu doing that. And then there's Cryptsy and Carbon Core, and they are building workflows and audit trails, and they're building procedures and methodologies. And that's another piece of the puzzle that is critical, and they're doing this, and it works with Guardian and it works on Hedera. And Envision is doing this, allowing you to create tokens easily. You have to make it easy to do these things. So given all of this, this huge ecosystem, I would invite you to join this ecosystem. Get involved. You can create carbon credits, or you can consume carbon credits, or you can record your emissions. The question is, what green future will you build? Thank you.